Welcome to this forecasting tutorial on exponential smoothing. We will be calculating forecasts using exponential smoothing. We will also be calculating the mean squared error for the forecasts. We will be calculating exponentially smooth forecasts for these sales values collected over a 7-week period. The actual sales will be represented by AT. Note that some authors use YT to represent actual values. Forecast values, on the other hand, are generally represented by FT. The exponential smoothing method uses the formula FT plus 1 equals FT plus alpha times AT minus FT, where alpha is a value between 0 and 1, referred to as the smoothing constant. This means that our forecast for the current period is obtained by adding the forecast in the last period to a fraction of the error from the last period. To make calculations easier, this formula can be rewritten as FT plus 1 equals alpha AT plus 1 minus alpha FT. That is, the new forecast equals alpha times the last actual value plus 1 minus alpha times the last forecast value. We will be using this second formula for our calculations. Note that both formulas will give the same result. It is just a little easier to use the second one. So our first objective is to calculate exponential smoothing forecasts using alpha equals 0.2. Since alpha equals 0.2, then 1 minus alpha will be 1 minus 0.2, which equals 0.8. Then the formula becomes 0.2 times the actual values plus 0.8 times the forecast values. Since the forecast required both actual and forecast value from the last period, we are sometimes given a forecast value for the first period. If no forecast value for the first period is given, then we assume F1 equals A1. That is, the first forecast value is assumed to be the first actual value. So F1 equals 39. We then calculate F2 as 0.2 times 39 plus 0.8 times 39, which again will always give the same value, 39. As a result, we just usually assume that F2 equals A1 and not bother calculating it at all. That is, if F1 is not given, we simply start by copying whatever value we have in A1 into F2. This means that our first real use of the formula begins with F3. So F3 is going to be 0.2 times 44 plus 0.8 times 39, which gives 40. Consequently, F4 will be 0.2 times 40 plus 0.8 times 40, which gives 40. For F5, we have 0.2 times 45 plus 0.8 times 40, which gives 41. For F6, 0.2 times 38 plus 0.8 times 41, which gives 40.4. F7 equals 0.2 times 43 plus 0.8 times 40.4, and that gives 40.92. We can also forecast week 8 as 0.2 times 39 plus 0.8 times 40.92, which gives 40.54. Next, we compute the mean squared error. To obtain the mean squared error MSE, we first obtain the forecast errors, square them, and then find the mean or average of the squared errors. When computing errors for exponential smoothing forecasts, we do not calculate an error for period 1 unless otherwise stated. So the forecast error for week 2 is 44 minus 39, which is 5. For week 3, it is 40 minus 40, which gives 0. For week 4, it is 45 minus 40, which gives 5. For week 5, it is 38 minus 41, which gives negative 3. For week 6, it is 2.6. And for week 7, it is negative 1.92. Next, we square the errors. Starting with week 2, 5 squared is 25, 0 squared is 0, 5 squared is 25, negative 3 squared is 9, 2.6 squared is 6.76, and negative 1.92 squared is 3.69. Since we only have 6 periods with errors, we add up these errors and divide by 6 to obtain a mean squared error of 11.58. And that's how to calculate forecasts, an MSE, with exponential smoothing. Please leave a question or comment below, and thanks for watching.